Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video tutorial, I will show you how to group row and column field items in the React Pivot Table component of Syncfusion. I will also explore different types of grouping, number, date and custom in depth. Let me open my existing example, where I installed the Syncfusion React Pivot View package. I have already bound JSON data using the data source property. Let's have a look at the data bound to the data source. It contains fields like date, product categories, product ID, etc. And these fields are mapped to the row, column, and value axes. You can refer to my Getting Started video, shared in the card above or in the description below to learn more about local JSON data binding. I'll run this application. See, the pivot table is rendered based on a JSON object. Here you can see, the date field items are not displayed in a proper format. Let's see how to format these field items and then we move on to grouping. To change the format, include format settings property in data source settings and map the field date using the name property. Then, specify the data type as date and set the date format to be displayed. Note that, type should start with lowercase. Now, you can see, the date field items are displayed based on the specified format. To group data, I import the module grouping from the React Pivot View package and inject it to the Pivot View services. Then I enable the Allow Grouping property. See here, when I right-click the row header, group option is shown. Click that, and the grouping dialog will open. Since this is a date field, you will find the date picker for starting it, ending it options, and the multi-select drop-down for interval by option. The first two options are used to set a range, and based on that, row or column header will be grouped. To set the start date, I need to enable the date time picker by clicking the starting it checkbox. Here, I enter or select the start date and time. In the same way, I click ending it checkbox and enter the end date. You will see the row header grouped based on the provided dates and intervals based on month. Items other than the specified range will be considered out of range. I can also group the field items in different sections such as years, quarters, months, days, hours, minutes, and seconds using this interval by option. To group based on the years, choose the year first, followed by the month. Now, the row axis renders with years, and when you expand the years, months will be displayed. Next, I will show how to perform grouping at initial loading with this example. I include group settings and map the date field using the name property. I set type to date and group intervals to years and months. Then set the range using the starting at and ending at properties. Check now, while loading this example, row field items are grouped based on the provided range and interval. To ungroup the data, right-click the row or column header and click the ungroup option. When I right-click the column header, group option will be shown. Click that, and grouping dialog will open. Since the data type of this field is number, you can find the starting at, ending at, and interval by options with numeric text boxes. To set the start range, I need to enable the numeric text box by clicking the starting at checkbox. Here I will enter or select the range value 1004. In the same way, I click ending at checkbox and enter the end range 1008. You can see the column header grouped based on the provided range with an interval of 2. Items other than the specified range will be considered out of range. I can also group the field items in different intervals using this interval by option. I set the interval by value to 3. Now, column axis items renders with an interval of 3. Next, I will show you how to perform number grouping at initial loading with this example. In the group settings, I map the product ID field using the name property. Set type to number and range intervals to 3. Then set the range using the starting at and ending at properties. Check now, while loading this example, column field items are grouped based on the provided range interval. Finally, I will show you how to perform custom grouping. First, change the data type of the product ID field to string, and comment out the group settings. Then I select one or more column headers and click the group option. In the grouping tab, I specify the field caption and group name as sold products. Look, selected column headers displayed under the specified group name. To group custom field items at initial loading of this example, I need to provide the type as custom in group settings. I specify the caption as unsold products. Then, I include the custom groups property to specify the group name and group items. I set the group name to unsold products and provide the group items as 1004, 1005, and 1006. Check here, the pivot table is rendered based on the specified custom grouping. In this video, I showed you how to group pivot table row and column field items based on date, time, number, and string types. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. I've also included a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use all our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.